Hey everybody, welcome back to Thrash Metal Homebrew. This is Brian. Last Wednesday, Mr. Drunken One himself had called me and a couple other people out to do the seven questions. And I'm going to go ahead and take this time to do the seven questions. And then I got to figure out who I am going to have do it next. So, yeah, cheers. Middle of the week. You know how it's going with me. So cheers. Just got done with day three workout. Cheers. One of the ingredients of beer. Gotta love it. All right, so let's, some people say, without further ado, we're gonna go with question number one. And question one is, why do you do YouTube? And the reason why I do YouTube is I have watched quite a few people over the years put out some pretty good content on subject matter that I think was very interesting. And I'm one of those people that I'm not a master at anything, but I know a lot about a lot of things. So, for instance, you know, I learned my way up doing homebrew, of course, and just other things, some automotive stuff. My military stuff taught me, some ham radio stuff. I was a single sideband AM radio person, so anything that's ham radio type related stuff, teletype, the old 31 Charlie sitting in the back of a rat rig doing teletype over single sideband around the world, that was me. Another thing, antenna systems. I was so good with antenna systems, I used to train in the military before I got out. So, I'm doing YouTube because I want to share what I've learned in some, be part of the community for one, especially in the homebrewing community, and you know, right now the workout community as well. So I'm trying to step that up as well. So I'm kind of sharing time on doing video logs on that, just to let people know my perspective of things and kind of a more realist aspect, especially when it comes to working out. Because people are like, yeah, you just jump into it and all of a sudden people just fall out. Well, there's no real story behind it when you sit there and watch people do their, you know, why they fell out. So I like to know the substance behind it. So, you know, like my video diaries when I'm working out, I'm going to be telling people my pains and what I'm going through and how I'm so sore today that I was barely able to do the push-ups. And I still, you know, sucked it up and went, got through it, but let people know why I had that pain. So, that, you know, that's one thing. So I think that answers number one. I like, why do you do YouTube? I like to share my knowledge on some subject matters or show a different style of doing things. So number two is, when did I start? I started YouTube February 2 years ago, so it's been just over 2 years I've been doing the YouTube thing. I've been doing uploads. I've been on YouTube since 2006, I think. 2006 or 2009, one of the two. I think it's 2009. You know, just uploaded some stuff of graduations, you know, football games my son was playing in, and my other son playing in a football game, and my other son doing marching band. So I had all these different things out there. So 2009 is when I started, but started getting heavy into doing the uploads for homebrew and all that back in 2 years ago. So 2015, February 2015. How did I come up with my name? I just didn't want to go out there and just put some name out there. I started off with my name, so Brian Fisher, of course, and then just recently Thrash Metal Homebrew. That name's been on my videos almost the time that I started uploading for the homebrew stuff. So the reason why I came up with Thrash Metal Homebrew is that I wanted to put kind of a, I wanted to put some edge on my videos compared to others because of the music that I listen to. I think it's my music, you know, everyone thinks their music's the best, but when it comes to the thrash metal portion of it, I think thrash metal is one of those genres of music that gets you going. It pumps you up. It's got a better rhythm to it than the regular stuff that's going on, especially, you know, in the 90s. See, I'm a child of, you know, my 20s were in the 80s, so I got to deal with the hair bands and Metallica when it first came out, Megadeth, all that stuff. So yeah, I did all that. Sorry about the dogs barking in the background. But that's how I came up with it. I wanted to have some edge on my content. So, and you see it in my videos. I play heavy stuff beginning, during, and after the video. So I think it's kind of cool. It's kind of a cool thing for me to do. So I think that answers that one. Number four, how long do I plan on doing YouTube? I plan on doing YouTube until either I get sick of it or my subscribers go to zero, because I guess my content ain't worth anything, but I'll keep doing YouTube as long as I can. So that answers that. Do I make my own thumbnails? Sometimes I get them off the internet. Sometimes I make them my own. Do I make my own, number six, do I make my own intros and outros? So the majority of the content is mine, but there are some things that I did find on the internet that was considered free that I went ahead and included. So like the explosion and, you know, the fiery metal, you know, metal fingers, you know, and then it blows up and all that. That stuff I kind of acquired. So in other words, I hacked it. So yeah, that's me. So if you want them back, you have to watch my videos. All right. So what cameras do I use? Right now I'm filming on an iPod SE, and it is the freebie one I got from work, and I just use that for videos, and then I also use it for work, of course. And then I also have on my computer one of these Logitech old webcams. I think I've had this thing for, God, 15 plus years, maybe? I got it when it was new. It was a shiznik. That thing is kind of grainy. The iPhone, this guy is the clearest one I have. I also have my Android, so I have a Droid Max that I use sometimes. And then I also have a handheld one that I was using for when I was going up to my son's football games in college and stuff. I'll do that one when I'm having long brew days, or if I want to. I haven't done the multiple angle stuff, but I would use that for the multiple angles if needed. So those are the types of cameras I have. So that's the seven questions. I'd like to choose three people to do the seven questions as well. And I'm going to go ahead and pause the video here and then find out who three I want to do. And I'll be right back. All right, thanks for hanging out for that quick second. My three, make beer easy, Big Rob. You got to do it, Big Rob. Another person I'd like to see do it. Let's see. Dun-dun-dun-dun. Count Druncula. Count Druncula. I'm calling you out. And let's see. Oh, let's see here. If Rusty hasn't done it, I'd like to see Rusty Homebrew do it. So Rusty, I'm calling you out as well. I'm going to go ahead and put links to their channels down below. And we'll see you guys answering those questions. So, guys, thanks for tuning in. Remember, keep rocking, keep doing what you're doing, never stop homebrewing. Like I said at the beginning, this is one ingredient to making beer. Cheers. Just flicked it everywhere. Cheers, guys. Have a really good week, and I'll see you on the next video.